now we'll see what is the transposition technique. So what is transposition? It is nothing but changing the position of the bits. In the substitution, we said we have to replace every alphabet with the other alphabet depending upon the key. But in the transposition, what we are going to do is we are going to transfer the bit so that we can confuse the attacker or unauthorized person and he cannot understand the original data. So we have to follow the two steps in order to do the transposition. The first one is arrange the character of the text in matrix, and the second is shuffle the rows and columns. If you follow these two steps, we can do the transposition technique very successfully. We'll see another example. Yes, this is the example. See here, if I take a begin operation, yes, this is my plain text, begin operation at noon. What I'm going to do is, as I said in the steps, first I have to convert my plain text to the matrix form. So the first step is we represent text in the form of 5 into 4 matrix in the row major form. First, in order to write the plain text into the matrix form, I have to convert it into 5 into 4 matrix. So BEGI. So I am writing B, N comes here, OPE, like this. I am making it as a 5 into 4 matrix. The first step is done. What is the second step now? So it has to be the rows and the columns should be shifted or shuffled. So if you see these protocols like a row 1 to row 3, row 2, it is not always constant. It can be user defined. Whatever you want, you can make it. You can make it as row 3 to row 2, row 4 to row 3. Like that, it is your wish. You can change this protocol or these conditions in your own way. So I'm taking the same data which I have converted into matrix, and what is said here, row 1 should go to row 3. So what happens, my row 1 is BEGI, that goes to row 3, and what is row 2? Row 2 is NOPE, that goes to row 5, and my row 3 is RATI, that goes to row 2, and row 4 is ONAT, that should go to row 1, and row 5 should go to row 4. So like this I am moving. This is called row transposition. See, if your data needs like less secure, it is less secure data, it doesn't require that much security, then what you can do, you can stop with the single row transposition. If you want to give more security, then you can go for the column transposition also. So similarly, we have to, instead of doing in the row wise, you have to do with the column wise. See, this is column transposition. As I said before, if this is user defined, you can take any rule like this. What is it? Column 1 should go to column 4. What is column 1 here? It is ORBNN. This goes to column 4. And column 2 should go to column 3. So it goes to column 3. And ATGOP, it is nothing but column 3 should go to column 1. So it goes here. And column 4 goes to column 2. So our column transposition is done. So now again back to, we have to convert this matrix form into the ciphertext. So write as it is, like ATNOTIARGIEBONONPEON. Since while writing the plain text to the data, we have written row wise. We have written row wise there. So the same thing should be followed here. Whatever process we have followed at the encryption, the same process should be followed in the decryption also, to get the plain text. That's it. So if you want to increase more security, you can do any number of row transposition as well as the any number of column transpositions to make it so complicated. That should be agreed by both the sender and the receiver. That is most necessary. So this is how our transposition techniques works, which involves two steps. The first one is just take the data, convert it into the matrix form. The second is do the row transposition, and the third step is column transposition, and write it back again to the text. Convert the matrix to the text, that will be your ciphertext. The decryption also follow the same steps to convert back into the plain text. This is how our transposition technique works, which is very simple. Next, we'll move on to the topic, that is confusion and diffusion. What is confusion? Confusion refers to making the relationship between the key and the ciphertext as complex and as involved as possible. Why we have to, there should not be any relationship between the key and the ciphertext. Why? That is actually said by the confusion. Why there should not be any relationship between the ciphertext and the key is, if we find any relation, if any attacker finds it, he can guess it very easily. He can guess the data very easily with the help of the relationship between the ciphertext and the key. So it should always, it is always advisable that the, it should not provide any clue. The confusion is a property of cipher where it provide by it provides no clue regarding the relationship between the ciphertext and the key. Okay, what is diffusion then? Diffusion refers to the property that redundancy in the statistics of the plain text is dissipated in the statistics of the ciphertext. See, if S is used, see, in the English we'll be using S more frequently. So wherever the S is used, if you are going to replace with the T, then he can very easily understand what is the key of that. So if the same pattern of plain text is repeated in the corresponding ciphertext, then he can guess the key very easily. So guessing the key with the help of the with the relationship between the plain text and the ciphertext pair is nothing but diffusion. Next. Yes. What is block cipher and the stream cipher? See, if the data is very large, then we have to convert the data into the blocks, into blocks, and we have to apply the encryption techniques to convert it into the ciphertext. Because it is not always possible to go with a bulk of data and to convert the encryption techniques. So what we have to do is, so if I am going to convert my data into number of blocks and apply the encryption algorithm over it, then it is block cipher technique. And in case of a stream cipher, what can I do is, I can convert the data into the streams. What is stream? Stream is nothing but it involves encryption and the decryption of one byte of the text at a time. So one byte it takes, and apply encryption and the decryption techniques. Whereas in the block cipher technique, we have divided the data into a block. One block will be taken and apply the encryption and the decryption techniques. So what are the examples of block ciphers? Is DES, data encryption standard, AES, advanced encryption standard, RSA, ECC. And the examples of stream ciphers, one-time pad, RC4. But practically, we are using this DES, AES and RSA more than the stream ciphers, since it is very easy to go with the bulk data. So with this, we are completing our this cryptography chapter. We'll see in the next session. Bye-bye.